Let's talk about some of these odds. So Daniel Berger is plus 1,100. He has been like quietly strong out here. He has 7 top 20s in his last 10 starts. This is just his 4th non-major since the Masters. He's been pretty good for the last 2 months, and he is on the fringe of qualifying for the 2021 Ryder Cup, so he has a lot to play for. Do you think his odds are too high or too low?
You know, you look at Daniel Berger plus 1,100. It was the last time we saw Daniel Berger as like this big a favorite. And it kind of, you just kind of, you know, hold your nose. Like, I don't want a part of this. But you look at this field and this event and what Berger's done lately, and this makes a ton of sense. If anything, Jesse, I would almost say his odds are a little bit bigger than they probably should be. This is the number 16th ranked player in the world. The next highest ranked player in this field is Sung Jae Im number 27, who's been in far worse form than Daniel Berger. Daniel Berger's coming off a T7 at the U.S. Open, gained plus 6.7 strokes on approach there. He's hitting the ball great. He's hitting it very consistently, too, week in, week out. Now, look, we have seen players, top players like Jordan Spieth, Francesco Molinari, come to this event right before the Open and play really well. Spieth won it one year. Francesco Molinari finished second 1 year. Berger can absolutely do it this week. He's in good enough form. He's definitely, like you said, going to be hunting for Ryder Cup points and just some form before the Open. I don't actually hate this. Now, I would rather play him as like a top 5 at plus 225 or maybe a top 10 at plus 100. But as far as his odds go, no, these are right where they should be. And if anything, I'd say they're even a little bit too big.
All right, let's talk about Brian Harman, plus 1,600. He's been crashing top fives, 10s, and 20s through 2021. TPC Deer Run in 2014, he is 5-for-7 overall with 4 top 25s. What do we think, plus 1,600?
Yeah, I mean, look, Brian Harman's a nice player. He's a great putter. He sets up very well for the course this week. But a plus 1,600, like, he's not in the same class as Berger. He's not in the same class as Sung Jae Im, who is also plus 1,600. He is in the class of guys like Kevin Streelman, plus 2,500. You know, even like an Alex Noren, plus 3,000. Like, the fact those guys are almost double in odds of Brian Harman, it just kind of shows you how short Brian Harman is this week. Short, literally, on the course and in the odds as well. But this is a player who I'm just not interested at this price. I think he's an interesting DFS play if you want to play him in cash games. He's got a very good record at the John Deere. Obviously won it here, I believe it was in 2014, 2015, one of the two. But regardless, he's got a great record at the Deere. He fits well for the course. But for an outright odds, there's just too many similar players above him to really catch my attention here. So if anything, Brian Harman coming in too low this week in the odds.
All right, Siwoo Kim is plus 3,500. He's kind of been all over the place, up and down, hard to predict, don't you think?
Yeah, I mean, that is Siwoo's style, right? I mean, he misses a couple cuts. You're like, what's going on? And then he flashes with like a top 10 at a major or something. This is a very talented golfer. He's got 3 wins on the PGA Tour already. And, you know, plus 3,500. Again, you have to look at these players, like, who is around them in the odds. Siwoo Kim is the number 50 ranked player in the world. Like I said, he's a very, very talented, South Korean player. Still very young, and he's a guy who can light up a course like this. 2 of his wins have come, you know, at Birdie Fest, you know, at the American Express earlier this year, and at the Wyndham in 2017. So this is a good style of course for Siwoo Kim. And you look at who's around him in the odds. You got Seamus Power, who's kind of just like a career, just like Corn Ferry, goes between the tour type player. Zach Johnson, who's 45 years old. Steve Stricker's at plus 4,000. Like, Siwoo Kim is not in these class of players. And I say he's not in these class of players because he's above them. He should be at least, you know, around plus 3,000, plus 2,500. So I think you're getting good odds here to take a shot on him. Siwoo did make the cut last week. He played fine. He could definitely pop with the putter this week and make some noise. So I think you're getting very good odds on him.
All right, finally, Kevin Na, plus 4,500. What do you think, too high or too low?
No, I think these are a little bit too high. It's a very similar story to Siwoo Kim. I mean, you look at who's around Kevin Na in the odds. You know, Maverick McNealy never won on tour. Very, very inconsistent. Troy Merritt's playing good, so maybe I shouldn't besmirch his name too much. But again, Kevin Na is a guy we've seen win, you know, like each year the last 3 years. This is a player who can get insanely hot with the putter. He fits TPC Deer Run to a T. He loves these style of events. To win a TPC Deer Run, you have to just get insanely hot with the putter, gain over 7 strokes. That's Kevin Na's thing. He's one of the best putters on tour, if not the best putter on tour. And look, his form a little bit up and down, but a plus 4,500, these are more than generous enough to take a shot. Again, I think he's sort of the class of the tier he's stuck in the odds this week.